Well, I think I've lost total respect for you, Dad.
Magic moments when two hearts are kept. Magic moments, memories we've been sharing. I'll never forget the moment we kissed the night of the hayride. The way that we hugged to try to keep warm while taking the sleigh ride.
Magic moments, memories we've been sharing. Magic moments filled with love.
So, George, how was your day at work?
No, Brenna, dear. As usual, strangled two cats and rolled an epileptic horse into a swimming pool. And say, where's Candy and her new boyfriend?
Well, I thought she would have been here by now. She hasn't stopped talking about him. I think he's the one.
Yeah, I wonder what he's like.
Yeah. Oh, hi, hon. Where's the boyfriend?
He's coming.
Ooh.
I've got some really exciting news!
Okay.
Mom? Dad? This is Randy P. Variant, the third. And we're getting married!
What?
Yeah, we're getting married! He's the only man I've ever loved and ever will love.
Oh, no, you don't, young lady. I won't stand for this. He's old enough to be your
grandfather. He's also the only man I've ever met with 14 houses, 30 cars, and as many profitable organizations.
Whoa.
What?
Pleasure to meet you, Randy.
Yeah. Hi.
Welcome to the I am so excited and so happy. You know, Candy, I always envisaged that you would marry some young, hedonistic, good-looking hooligan on a motorcycle. But you chose to marry into money, and I couldn't be prouder. You know, I'm excited about planning this wedding. You're going to get married like every other Valentine girl for six generations.
Well, how do the others get married, Mom?
Right here in this house, son. It's an old Valentine tradition. I'm damn proud of it. It's where my grandfather, my great-great-grandfather, built this house with his own two hands.
Sounds great.
Yeah.
Oh, who could that be?
Praise! Council representative, everybody down on the ground.
What is this? Who the hell are you?
I'm Mr. Black, council representative. This is an official document outlining the demolition of your house to make room for a new freeway by order of the council.
Oh, no, you don't. We're Valentines. We're not going to stand for that. My great-great-grandfather built this house with his own two hands.
You will do what I tell you. You've got 1 week to move out. I am the law.
Ooh. Ooh. What a strange fellow. Charming, but very strange.
I won't stand for this, Deirdre. By hook or by crook, you'll be getting married in this house, Candy.
Hooray!
I will die peacefully, sleeping in the bed that my own father bought for Mattress King with his own two hands. Yeah.
Dad, does this mean we're going to fight City Hall?
What? I guess it does, Tommy. We're Valentines, goddammit. We'll fight. We'll fight to the death. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, who wants some of Mom's beautiful Bombay, 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 Alaska?
Yeah.
They have a very strong case here. There's only one place to settle this.
Mm-hmm.
In a court of law.
Well, I guess we should probably get a lawyer then, huh, George?
A lawyer? Hell no. When I was wading knee-deep through the blood of my own platoon back in Nam, did I need a lawyer?
No.
No. God, when I was fighting off wave after wave of those damn Charlies, did I need a lawyer?
No.
No. And what about when I ran over your damn mother? Well, did I need a lawyer?
Well, George, you probably wouldn't have spent 10 years in Sing Sing if you'd got a lawyer for that last one.
Don't be irrelevant, dear. The fact of the matter is I can handle this case myself. Yeah. I'm my own best defense. Because I'm not going to take this lying down. My grandfather built this house with his own goddamn hands, for Christ's sake.
That's right, hon.
Oh, no, I think Dad needs some help with this one.
Do I have eyes, Sigmy?
No, I don't know, Randy, no. Wait. Yeah. I'll call in some old friends.
Someone? Do I have something?
Yeah.
All rise. We now bring to court the case of George Valentine versus City Hall. Will the defendant please approach the stand? Who will defend you, Mr. Valentine?
I would like to defend myself, Your Honor.
Very well. Your opening argument.
I don't think it's fair, you bastards are knocking down my house.
That's your opening argument?
Well, I guess. What else do you want me to say?
Candy?
Oh yeah! Cause this is gonna be the best wedding ever! Why can't I just have it in a normal church?
Oh, come on, hon. You know it means the world to your father to have you married in this house, where 6 generations of Valentine women have been married before. You know your father's a stickler for this stuff, don't you? Don't you?
Yippee-ki-yay, motherfuckers! Everybody down on the ground.
What do you want? Haven't you terrorized my family enough?
Just a friendly reminder now. In 4 days' time, this place is going down.
Well, I don't think so, young man. Because right this minute, my husband George is fighting for this home in City Hall.
You can't fight City Hall. I am the law.
Yeah. Bye-bye, little man. You know, I wish he wouldn't just keep dropping around like that. I think he'd at least call first. How rude.
And that's why I'm proud of my one remaining testicle.
Just about enough, Mr. Valentine.
Wait, Your Honor. I have a character witness that would have liked to approach a stand.
Really? Well, who is he?
He's my long-lost friend. He's my dog.
Very well. Mr. Dog.
Your Honor, I'm George's dog. You know, the Valentines are very hospitable folks. This one time, George let me and a couple of needy friends sleep in his very own bed. He even kicked out his wife to make room for us. That George is a fine gentleman.
I don't see the relevance, Mr. Valentine.
Wait, Your Honor. George may not be the brightest man, He may not be the best looking man. He may not even smell that good. But goddamn it, he's a man, all right. I should know. I'm a dog.
Well, I think I've heard everything I want to hear. I'm ready to give my verdict. Mr. Valentine, are you ready to receive it?
Yes, Your Honor.
Mr. Valentine, I think you're insane. You talk to the family pet. I'm not sure the pet is alive. Your brain patterns are that of a fig tree. Yay, hi. I have no choice but to condemn you to a life inside a mentalist.
Johnny! You freaking bastard! Johnny!
Yeah! Oh, George, stop fooling around. Oh, you're a card. George. Oh, I love you, Georgie. George.
I'll never forget the moment we kissed the night of the hayride.
What are you laughing at, son?
The way that we hugged to try to keep warm, taking the sleigh ride back.
George, who loves you, George? Huh? Georgie, Burton and Pride. Georgie. Remember our honeymoon, George? Remember our wedding night, George? Georgie.
Well, George, you probably wouldn't have spent 10 years in Sing Sing.
You're not fine. A good friend of mine told me something that would make you feel a whole lot better.
Shit.
When two hearts are caring,
hey, Mr. Black,
I can't erase the memory of these magic moments filled with love.
Fine.
The way that we cheered when we were on team was scoring a touchdown. The time that the floor fell out of my bar when I put the clutch down. The Halloween hop when everyone came in funny disguises. Magic.
Girls in the slumber parties? Keep it down in there, girls!
Sorry.
They got a gay Chinaman in there.
Yeah.
This one.
Sorry, it's nice, boy.
I don't know, Randy.
Cass! Going from well, Georgie.
I think Dad's gonna need some help on this one.
Zuber
is like, sorry. I don't know.
Cut.
I'm fucking sorry.
Dead.
I'm sorry, sorry.
We're dead.
We get more
laughs. I'm sorry.
Fucking hell!
What do you mean? More laughs? What the fuck are we doing?